then at the end of that year, I went to a function at the Park Plaza Hotel. It was to honor Tom Flatley. Now, I didn't know Tom Flatley personally up to that moment, but I had read all about him. I knew about him. He was, at the time, on his way to being a billionaire, but he owned all the hotels and golf courses. And he was from Ireland. So he was an inspiration to the likes of me. And I really wanted to meet him. So I borrowed a suit, and I went with three friends to the Park Plaza. Now I was down to about $100 at this stage. I had no money. I was just about to get on that Aer Lingus plane and head east. There he is. He was awarded something that night for his charitable contributions. And I said to my friends, who had a few beers in them, I didn't drink. I said, I'm going to talk to Tom Flatley. And they said, he'll never talk to you. He just won't do it. He's a billionaire. He's up in this plateau and you're here. And that was true. But I knew that this was my last chance. So I made my way up to Tom Flatley. And I said, Mr. Flatley. Now I'm shaking at the time. I said, Mr. Flatley, attorney. He said, yes. So how can I be successful like you? He wore big glasses. He pushed them up and he said, how old are you, kid? And I said, I'm 21 years old. Now there's about 2,000 people in the room. And he was able to say to me, he said, have you met those three guys? I said, yeah. He said, they're drunk. Are you? He said, let me tell you something. If you want to be successful in America, there's one thing you have to do, and you've got to do it now. You've got to change your environment. Success is out there for everybody. If you're in the wrong environment. So he said, you've got to get rid of these guys. I said, I grew up with these guys. I met one of the guys here. He's still known today, but we're just not that friendly. He said, listen to me one more time. You want to be successful, you've got to make that commitment and get rid of it. They're holding you back. I remember being in your position. He said, wow. I said, I'm saying to myself, I can't get rid of it. So I walked away. He said, good luck, kid. And I walked away. They said to me, well, what did he say? So I said, hang on a second, I gotta go back and clarify something. So I'm back up to Flatley and I said, Mr. Flatley, you tell me that I'm not supposed to go home with these guys. And he said, Dennis, the secret, this now is, if you go home with those guys, stay with them. But if you want to get to the next level in your life, he said, you've got to separate yourself from them. And you know what I did? It was January. I walked from the Park Plaza to Roslindale Square. I had to make that commitment. And the next morning, and it's public record, the next morning I went down and I started the company that I still own today.